Greetings. This will be the seventh video in the series regarding the direct relationship of major earthquakes and the solar eclipse. This video will be focusing on Australia, specifically the east coast of Australia. We're now looking back at some important historical earthquake events near the east coast of Australia. Bundaberg region Gander had two large earthquake events in August of 1883 and April of 1935. Both events were preceded by solar eclipse termination points. The magnitude 5.9 earthquake of 1883 was significant. Note the entry point of the eclipse just offshore Australia and into the Tasman Sea. Also note the double blue lines representing the path of totality. And the next earthquake of 1935, magnitude 5.4 earthquake, struck Gander. This time we note the annual solar eclipse that preceded marked in red, and the path of totality is just ending or terminating just north of the region. On a side note, 1883 was also significant for another reason. A major volcanic eruption occurred in Krakatoa, a VEI-6 eruption, one of the most powerful eruptions in history. Note that the 1882 solar eclipse is showing a termination node or entry point of the solar eclipse just north of Australia coming out of Indonesia, the same signature of many very large earthquakes in Indonesia's history, and this foreshadowed the major volcanic eruption that occurred the following year. This shows the important aspect of the entry and exit points of the solar eclipse, and it should be looked at very closely as it reveals the likely areas that could receive major geophysical events in the very near future. And it's my hope that these videos may shed some more light into the Sun-Moon relationship and Earth movement through it. And while we focus around Indonesia, just one more aspect which will be important. The annual solar eclipse of 1998 had an interesting termination node just entering the Great Sumatran Fault. Note the green dotted area also focus over the Cocos Islands. Just 2 years after this annual solar eclipse, we had two major earthquakes registered to 7.9 magnitude. The first event, a magnitude 7.9 earthquake, struck the Great Sumatran Fault, a megathrust earthquake that killed 103 people. And just 14 days later, we had a follow-up event, also 7.9 magnitude, this time further south near the Cocos Islands, which produced a tsunami. Note the 14-day differential, which is part of a lunation. Note the green dotted line on these charts. It's a representation of the next movement of the SARA cycle, or its next step. Or if we're looking at the animation, it'll depict the limit of the orange orb of the shadow of the moon, or the moon's second contact with the Earth. The 98 and 99 annual solar eclipse share an interesting symmetry. Note the path of totality as the red line. But the important aspect is the position or location of Cocos Islands on the green dotted line. Now we're going to tie in the 1998 and 1999 solar eclipse and why they're important for this video, as it represents a mirrored reflection or a repeat symmetry into 2027 and 2028 solar eclipses, which have a termination node and also a path of totality focus over Cocos Island, Christmas Island, and also the Wharton Basin. And this is a foreshadow for a major event at the end of this decade for the region. The 2028 solar eclipse is highly significant and will feature prominently for this video forecast, and it represents a significant earthquake threat for the east coast of Australia as well as into New Zealand. June 7, 1918, a magnitude 6 earthquake shook Bundaberg and Rockhampton, which caused serious damage in the region as well as into Gladstone. Note the solar eclipse foreshadow just 2 years prior. We're now looking at an animation of the 1916 eclipse. Note the red and orange shadows, which are most important. And at the termination of the red shadow, we note the orange shadow, or the moon's second contact focus over the Queensland and also the east coast of the Australian region. Newcastle had a 5.3 magnitude earthquake in 1925, December 18. Note the solar eclipse in 1922 also foreshadowed this event. Two major earthquake events could be attributed to the 1933 solar eclipse. Note that Gunning, a 5.6 magnitude earthquake, struck in November of 1934, a powerful earthquake. Notice the location within the orange orb, as well as Gander the following year in 1935. A 5.5 magnitude earthquake struck the region. A powerful magnitude 5.8 earthquake struck the West Tasman Sea, just northeast of Tasmania, or just near the Bass Strait. Significant earthquake in 1946, note the preceding solar eclipse in 1945, and the earthquake epicenter right on the path of totality. Now looking at the animation, note the orientation of the moon's appearance, seemingly changing shape from a circular to a pretty much an oval shape and then stretching out. Very interesting solar eclipse, as they all are, but this one is quite unique. A strong 5.5 magnitude earthquake struck Gunning in the Eastern Highlands of New South Wales, just north of Canberra. Note that this occurred in 1949, and just 4 months prior, the solar eclipse foreshadowed this event. The Coonamble Basin, New South Wales was struck by a 5.3 magnitude earthquake in May of 1961. Note there was a preceding solar eclipse in 1959 foreshadowing this event. We're now looking at the animation of this eclipse, and it's an interesting one. Note the orientation and shape of the orange shadow depicted in this animation. Note that the moon's actually changing shape to a circular to an oval and while switching directions. An interesting aspect that needs to be noted. The 1964 solar eclipse preceded two strong earthquakes for Victoria. 1966, a magnitude 5.7 earthquake struck Mount Hotham, Victoria. And just offshore, into the Bass Strait, another 5.7 magnitude earthquake struck the preceding year. All can be attributed to the 1964 solar eclipse. We're now looking at the animation of the eclipse. Note that the orange shadow depicted on this animation is showing it's scraping the coast of Victoria, right where the epicenter was of both of those quakes that occurred just offshore in Bass Strait. In 1973, a magnitude 5.5 earthquake struck Picton, New South Wales. It was preceded 14 months, with the solar eclipse foreshadowing this earthquake event for the region. We're now looking at the animation of this eclipse and note that the moon looks quite elongated, and this is due to being a partial solar eclipse. Now, when we have the moon depicted in this manner, we usually see some very large earthquakes offshore. There was a 5.4 magnitude earthquake that struck Wanangatta, Victoria in 1982. It was preceded by a 1981 solar eclipse foreshadowing this region. We're now looking at the animation and note that the entry point of the orange shadow, very close to the epicenter of this earthquake, and then the moon comes out, its red shadow, its first contact just south of Tasmania. A very violent and destructive earthquake struck Newcastle 1989 in December, a powerful event that registered by some agencies as high as 5.6 magnitude, killing 13 people. The tidal solar eclipse that occurred in 1986 foreshadowed this event. Now looking at the animation of this eclipse, and it's one of the better ones, where you can see the termination of the moon's shadow pretty much over the epicenter of the earthquake that was to occur 3 years later. Allenong, New South Wales had a 5.3 magnitude earthquake that struck in 1994. It was also preceded by a very significant tidal solar eclipse in 1991, which foreshadowed this event. When we're looking at the animation of this eclipse, note that the moon's entry is quite fast and violent. Then we see the change in orientation of the moon moving from side to side. These solar eclipses are quite difficult to forecast. A moderate earthquake registered a 4.8 magnitude struck Appin, New South Wales in 1999. It was preceded by a solar eclipse that foreshadowed this event 2 years prior. The animation shows the orange orb of the moon and its periphery coming very close to the epicenter of this earthquake that was to occur in 2 years' time. A series of rare and very significant earthquakes struck offshore Queensland in the years of 2015 and 16. A strong 5.4 magnitude earthquake struck offshore east of Fraser Island in July 2015. It was followed up a year later in August of 2016 with an even larger earthquake registered to 5.8 magnitude northeast of Bowen in Queensland. Now looking at the animation of the 2013 solar eclipse foreshadowing these earthquake events in the years to come. Note that the entry point just coming through West Australia and then stretching through Northern Territory and then moving through Queensland, just north of the epicenter, just offshore Bowen. In 2021, a powerful 5.9 earthquake struck Victoria, the Mansfield earthquake, of that year, striking the Governor Fault. This was a very significant earthquake, and even I felt this one. It was preceded by a 2018 solar eclipse, which actually foreshadowed this event perfectly. The 2018 solar eclipse was a partial eclipse, so we only get to see a yellow orb this time, but note that it's scraping Victoria, just like the previous one that occurred in Bass Strait. Note that its proximity and very close to the epicenter of this large earthquake that was to come. We're now looking ahead to 2025, and we see a very interesting solar eclipse. Note that its shadow is focused primarily over New Zealand and stretching southward. Now, this will be the foundation of strong shakes for the region, and I will be making a separate video for the New Zealand mainland. That'll be my next video upload, so keep note of that. We're now looking at an animation of the 2025 solar eclipse, noting that it does look primarily for New Zealand, but the yellow shade is scraping the coast of the east coast of Australia, stretching from north to south. A very interesting solar eclipse. But we also note that this could potentially be a fairly strong earthquake south of Australia and New Zealand. The years of 2028 and 2030 have two very potent solar eclipse termination and crossings that are foreshadows for a possible magnitude 6.5 earthquake event for the east coast of Australia in the years of 2030 to 2032. The main concern that this event may be land-based and not an offshore event. We're now looking at the second half of the 2028 solar eclipse and noting that it's moving through Australia, pretty much just south of Newcastle, and then stretching through the Tasman Sea and then terminating right through the South Island, New Zealand. A very potent and very significant solar eclipse, this one. We're now looking at the important solar eclipse of 2030 and its significance for the Australian mainland, especially the east coast of Australia. Note that the solar eclipse, we are looking at the termination node, but the moon is actually moving across some danger zones of South Australia, the Flinders Ranges. So it'll be moving through there once it crosses the Australian mainland and then starts ahead towards Queensland quite violently. And it terminates in the danger zone of the fault lines just near Bundaberg. So I'm concerned that a major earthquake event could be in that location of Queensland. And it could also be an event for Newcastle as well. So it's definitely a time frame to watch and monitor the period after the solar eclipse between 2030 and to 2033. It must be noted that we are getting two solar eclipses over a given region, and that's not a good sign, as it does present a significant earthquake potential. So from 2028 we get one solar eclipse, and then 2030 we get another. But they will be overlapping just between the years of 2030 to 2032. And then we start to have the influence of just one solar eclipse thereafter, and that will stretch into 2034. And that concludes this video for the Australian region, specifically the east coast of Australia, for a potential significant earthquake based on the solar eclipse termination nodes. For more information, please visit solarwatcher.net and quakewatcher.com, where there will be more information for members and subscribers, as well as website newsletters. Thanks for watching.